What y'all know about it? Supermodel, fresh out of Elle magazine, buy her own bottles. Hey y'all, what's up? It's your girl Aubrey, and welcome to Curb Logic. We are back today with another episode. I'm sorry I've been MIA for a few days. Life caught up to me and I had to hit the whoa because I'm like, let me get this together real quick. But I missed you guys. Whether you're new here or you're a faithful follower, welcome. My name is Aubrey and I'm just so excited for you guys to be here today and to interact with my profound epiphany that I had the other day that really, I want to get you guys' take on it. I want to see what you have to think. So, let's get started. I've been thinking, y'all, at what age did we realize that being a princess wouldn't cut out as a full-time job? Or like, that Prince Charming, I mean, whether he played a good game of hide and go seek, really doesn't exist. It gets me to thinking. So y'all, I'm about to spill some real tea. So get it together, get it ready. I feel like I had an epiphany the other day that I really wanted to discuss with you guys. So, real talk. At what age did we lose our imagination? What age did we let the naysayers get their advantage and start listening to what other people have to say, whether they're really truly listening to what we had to say? Just a little anecdote to start off the video. I remember in like first, second grade, my beautiful teacher, Mrs. Harrison, LOL, she's a goat. She told us one day to think about, what do we want to be when we grow up? And when I tell you, our class had the craziest bits of imagination that we could ever have. And we knew we were serious. Like, we were here. Like, Thomas was going to be an astronaut, no doubt. He going to be on the moon, maybe to Jupiter soon. I was going to be the famous celebrity. Like, Beyonce got stuff that'll be. Beyonce, if you're watching this, you know, you're still my girl. We're going to be homies, but like, we could flourish together. You know what I'm saying? Like, she never once knocked us down. We had crazy vivid dreams, and she made it seem like we could achieve every single one of them. So, where did we lose that spot? Now, y'all may be like, what? Where did this come from, Aubrey? Well, let's be real. I had a, you know, like I said, a quarter-life crisis. But I really was stressed out about my future, y'all. Like, I didn't know what I was gonna do in the past 3 weeks. I said I had everything planned, but, you know, when everybody's asking you, what's your plans after graduation? You know, you just think of the first thing that comes up to mind so they can get off your back. But sooner or later, you realize you really have to answer that question. And I didn't know the answer. I mean, I knew what I kind of wanted to do, but I didn't get the money for that. So we had to figure something out real quick. So when really sitting down and thinking about the future and what that entailed for me, it kind of got all these different feelings sparked up. Like, I started thinking of what did I really want to do? What did I want to spend the next 50 plus years of my life doing that I wouldn't be so miserable? And that's when I started thinking of, oh, if I was rich and famous, this would all have been so much easier. And then I started thinking of my childhood and how I really wanted to be famous. And that's what I'm here for today, to talk about. Why can't it be realistic? Why can't you really achieve those goals no matter how crazy they are? It sounds cliche, but who says you can't? So I'm gonna say something that I know you probably have heard a million times by everybody and their mama, but I'm gonna say it again because I'm not trying to say that mine over trumps everybody's, but I had an epiphany related to mine, so I feel like I needed to share it. You can truly and honestly put your mind to anything you want to do, and I guarantee you'll be a step closer than where you were before, and you're better off starting and achieving something than just to have that dream and never achieve it. Do it. What's stopping you? If it's money, figure out ways to do it. If it's time, organize yourself. Get make time. There's no excuse for you to do something that you really, truly want to do. If your heart's in it, then all you have to do is just tell yourself yes. So, I, today, am going to give you all the million-dollar question and answer, obviously. And if you guys ever feel generous enough, my Cash App is $AubHayes because I'm about to make all y'all dreams come true. I feel like Oprah over here, like, you get a dream, you get a dream, you get a dream. You get a dream. Don't forget about me when y'all rich and famous, y'all. For real. So, shall we begin? Y'all, I feel like SpongeBob and Mr. Krabs with the secret formula for the Krabby Patty. Like, this is some spicy, piping hot tea, y'all. So, the question, how do you truly and honestly achieve your dreams? Wait a minute, y'all. Hold your horses. Strap. Buckle up, because it's about to be a ride. Answer. Make a plan. Execute it. Period. I had to hit the wall one time because I was too geeked to share that with y'all. Make a plan and execute it. It sounds a lot easier than it actually is. Not to be negative or anything, but it does take a lot of time, especially to make that plan, y'all. Once it's worth it, once it's over, there's nothing that can stop you. Oh, and another thing. When achieving these goals and actually executing the plan, don't let yourself be your biggest critic. And don't let others have anything to say unless they're actually investing their time with you to incorporate this dream of yours and make it come true. If you really want to do it, just go for it. Like, what's the worst thing? I'm going to give you another side story because who doesn't like side stories? So for a dream for me was to always be a cheerleader or a dancer or something sort of like that. But you know, thick thighs save lives. Everybody was doubting me from when I was in middle school to trying out to high school. They were like, Aubrey, chill out. Like, we love you. You know, it's just baby fat, but like, you can't do that. That's not your scene. And I was like, whatever. So then, icing on the cake. Sophomore year, this guy, won't name no names. We're gonna name him Ricky. Ricky was like, Aubrey, I bet you $20 you can try out for the team and I'll make it. Went? First of all, I heard money. Cause I'm broke. So money what? Of course. Second, I heard a challenge, and I'm very competitive, so try me. And third, this is something I've always wanted to do, so why not? What's stopping me? So, throughout the preparation of cheerleading tryouts, I was over there looking at the girls. They were doing high kicks, jumps, flips. I was like, oh, that is not my ministry, honey. Aubrey, you could do anything these girls do if you put your mind to it. And that was like the deep, like, down deep, like Michelle Obama, Oprah in me. Like, she just popped out and was like, hey, shut up, like, you can do it. So I was like, dang, self, you know, you're not wrong, like, I can do it. And honey, when I tell you I did it, so at that moment when my name was called and it was time for me to go and perform, I gave it 120%, and I couldn't do any of the kicks or the jumps, but that damn sure didn't stop me from trying. Did I reach the ground an inch? A little bit, but hey, I got up. My toes left the ground, the premises. So I think that counts if I do say so myself. But what attracted them more than anything was my energy, my confidence. Like, who gonna tell me I can't do it? Who gonna tell me I didn't just do it? I know you're not. I know I'm not. So we did it. I did it, period. So after tryouts, I felt like I was on top of the world. Whether I made the team or not, y'all won't go tell me nothing. Y'all won't go tell me that I couldn't do it, that I couldn't try on next year or the year after that, because I am that girl. And I did that tryout. Who made the varsity cheerleading team? This girl. And who also got $20? This girl. And whose life was changed at that immediate action? This girl. And if you don't believe me, honey, here's pics. Wasn't I cute? Like, I mean, I still am cute, but like, that was like, dang, girl, like, what's going on? Years later, after like my senior year of high school, not only did I realize that this not only sparked a major jump in my confidence, but it also paved the way for other girls. I remember I was at cheerleading tryouts, hosting the tryouts now, and this one little chubby girl, so cute, I'll name no names, she came up to me and she was like, you are a real inspiration. Me thinking I'm just doing my thing, you know, trying to look good for myself, hitting them herkies like it ain't done. Because, you know, I learned after a while, because who gonna tell me I couldn't do it? Thank you. Thank you, next. But yes, she said I motivated her, and you don't understand how much that made me feel. Like, I did something earth-shattering that just for me, but honestly, it changed everybody else's life too. And that's what I did from that moment on. Who wasn't going to achieve no dreams? Who? If you truly want something in life, look at the steps that it takes to achieve it. Whether that's processing, how much time it'll take, how much money, how much effort and skill that it takes to invest in it to truly see it through, take that time out and do it. What? There's nothing stopping you, and that true list and that true steps to take will inevitably lead you to be able to execute it. And then after that, it's set. You're done. Like, you've achieved something that you've always wanted to achieve. If you want your Prince Charming or you want your handsome man with the house and the picket fence, go get it. You can't be scared to talk to dudes. Go on the website, find online date, talk to guys, flirt. Do what you gotta do to get yours, sis. If you wanna be an astronaut, girl, go to NASA. Go see what you gotta do. Go study the stars, the moon, and the planet, and what you can do to actually motivate and thrive in that field. Don't let nobody stop you. So all my beautiful and faithful followers, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Click that notification button down below so you can get all the juicy details 24/7. As always, it's your girl Aubrei, it's Curve Logic, and I can't wait to see what dreams come true of yours. Love you. See you soon.